Let us begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our sister Maureen has died with the Lord, so may she live with him in glory. Christ and rejoice to rise again to him. To those who raise with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seem, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction, but they are in peace. For if before men, indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine and shall dart about as sparks through stone. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their King forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with the holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
If I should walk in the valley of darkness, surely goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that, just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. For if we have grown into union with him through a death like his, we shall also be united with him in the resurrection. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that our sinful body might be done away with, that we might no longer be in slavery to sin. For a dead person has been absolved from sin. If, then, we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ raised from the dead dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going, or how can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Can you see it? We'll be here for a long time. First of all, for myself and St. John's, I want to offer condolences, assurances of prayers and support as we gather to remember Mo and her life and the good that she did. And in remembering the good that she did, that is one way we commend her to the Lord. By telling the good that she did, we say, "Dear Lord, dear God, this is the good that she did. This is why we commend her to you. And that you may take her to this place that you have prepared for her." It's been my own experience of Mo that my sense then that she could be ornery, maybe something of a character. But then, consider her classmates and all the things that I heard about concerning them. Sounds like a good group, a group I would maybe have had fun with, partly because of what I've heard, but also partly because of some of the pictures I saw in the back there. For example, there is one photo where she is on a beach, and next to her is a cooler and a couple of bottles outside on the grass. Now, I can't tell if the bottles are Coke bottles or beer bottles, or maybe something else. Anybody know what that was? Well, those are fun memories, good memories, and goodness to hold on to. We also know that she had quite an interesting life, I think. She worked in many different ways, in different areas, different places. Got to know many different people and had different skills and abilities in her life. Now, I would like to think that all those things can be seen to be her way of getting to heaven. And when Jesus says, "I am the way, the truth, and the life," which is true, we can believe that, to talk about the way, we might think of the way as being totally holy, angelic, and saint-like through this life, never making any mistakes, always praying, and being just a very good person. It sounds like, well, if not, that's okay. Part of her way to heaven was the way that she lived as one who did believe in God, who did believe in Jesus. Now, it also might sense that I think she liked being a Catholic. She was a faithful Catholic and a loyal parishioner. And that is part of the way that we can make it to the kingdom of God. For in this way of faithfulness and loyalty, not just with parish, but to family and friends, these are ways to get to the place that Jesus has prepared for us, and maybe is preparing for us. And so then we come here maybe sad and sorrowful, and rightly so, but also remembering the good times and remembering the good things that she did as part of her journey on the way. And so, as we celebrate her life, we might reflect on our own life. How are we doing going on the way ourselves? Part of the way to the place that God prepares for us is to know the truth and to know the life. To know the truth and then to live the life. That is the way to the kingdom of heaven. And that's going to be different for all of us. And that does not mean we're not going to have good times. Obviously, we can. That is perfectly okay. We can laugh, enjoy life, enjoy each other, enjoy the good times that God has given us. And then at the end, thank God for all those good times, for all our good friends and our family. This truth is underlined in the second reading from Paul's letter to the Romans. And Paul writes to the Romans that our old self was crucified with him, our sinful body might be done away with, because we no longer slavery to sin, all because of our baptism. Baptism changes everything, because we are baptized into his death and baptized into his life. Jesus' death and life and then resurrection. So this is our faith. This is how we begin our journey on the way. Through baptism, living that life, living the truth and the life that Jesus shows us is the way. Now, we also know that part of that way can be the way of suffering. And that suffering can be redemptive, as we say theologically, but that suffering, is another way of saying that our suffering can be united with Christ's suffering on the cross, and so make it meaningful. We can have meaning in suffering. And the way, then, is the way of the cross. And we can accept that, or we can resist that. that Jesus says, you know, this is the way. Take up your cross and follow me. And if you do, you will follow me to the cross, but also follow me to the resurrection and the place I have prepared for you. So then as we gather together to remember Marie and give thanks to God for where she was, which good that she did with us and for us, we also thank God for the gift of Jesus, who died for our salvation, who died for our sake, who wants us to know him and love him and follow him all the way to the kingdom of heaven. Stand. As we place our prayers and petitions before God our Creator.
For Marines, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, she may now be admitted to the company of the saints. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sister, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she be raised up on the last day. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of our sister Maureen, that they be consoled in their grief by the Lord. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, giver of all good gifts, we thank you for the gift that Maureen was for all of us. And we pray that through our prayers we may help her on her way to the kingdom of heaven. We ask all this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Please join me in singing number 680, Amazing Grace, 680.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Marie, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for it is at your summons that we come to birth, by your will that we are governed. and at your command that we return unto the sin to that dust from which we came. And when you give the sign, we who have been redeemed by the death of your Son shall be raised up to the glory of his resurrection. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, who gave life to all things and made them holy, and you never cease to gather good people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, my Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we brought you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, he suffered with him, that he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint John the Baptist, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation be prayed, O Lord, and advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Timothy, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Maureen, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters, too, and to all who are pleasing to hear for their passing from this life, give planted minister your kingdom. There, we hope we can joy forgiven the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the occasions, and praise you without end through Christ our Lord, through whom we bestow upon the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the same as commanded form of divine teaching, we know to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that, by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not in our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Our communion song is number 793, One Bread, One Body, 793.
Thank you.
Let us pray.
Our God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body through to the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister Maureen may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Trusting in God, we pray together for Maureen, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see her again and enjoy her friendship. Although we may disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. Certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon her in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In peace now, we take our sister to her place of rest. Let's conclude our prayers. My sister Maureen has gone to her rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome her to the table of God's children in heaven. With faith and hope in eternal life, let us assist her with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with our sister, and together may we meet Christ Jesus when he who is our life appears in glory. We read in sacred scripture, "Come, you who are blessed by my Father, says the Lord, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world." Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you, and so made the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection, even as it claims our mortal bodies. Grant that our sister may sleep in peace until you awaken her to glory, for you are the resurrection and the life. Then she will see you face to face, and in your life will see light and know the splendor of God. For you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Because God has chosen to call our sister Maureen from this life to himself, we commit her dust to the earth, for we are dust, and into dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory, for he is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So we commend our sister to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace her in peace and raise her up on the last day.
Amen.
for a prayer commendation, our response would be, Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn, and dry the tears of those who weep. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. You wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
You raised the dead to life. Give our sister eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
You promised paradise to the repentant thief. Bring Maureen to the joys of heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
She was washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give her fellowship with all your saints. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And she was nourished with your body and blood. Grant her a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And comfort us in our sorrow. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Now let us gather these prayers into the one Christ taught us as we pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Amen. God of holiness and power, accept our prayers on behalf of your servant. Do not count her deeds against her, for in her heart she desired to do your will. As her faith united her to your people on earth, so may your mercy join her to the angels in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let's pray for ourselves. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need, and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest be unto her, O Lord, and let her perpetual light shine upon her. And may her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
And may the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. And may Mo go with God's blessing in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. Yeah.